Olympic gold medalists in good form, winning 21-16, 21-10 in 37 minutes. Junior player is Rachel. And her Russian opponent is on her way.
The umpire is Iris Metspolo from
Evgeniya Kosetskaya.
Is Stefan Benet from France.
From Chelyabinsk, born, resides in Kazan these days. 1.76 meters tall, born in November 94, so 26 years of age.
Rachel, you have to choose red or black. Black, red for you. Black it is. Receive.
That's right. Okay. The Canadian, Rachel Chan, won the toss, elected to receive. Kosetskaya will stay at the far end of the court. In week 17 of this year, Rachel Chan was a women's singles runner-up of the Pan Am Individual Championships to Beiwen Zhan of the States. There's her confirmed ranking, 240 in the world, the 17-year-old. 1.65 meters from Markham in Canada. It's been as high as 233 in the world. As I say, contested the doubles against Polly and Raheyu on Monday when they went down hard to the Indonesians. To be expected, the Indonesians, of course, winners in the inaugural event out here in 1989, the Sudirman Cup. And in singles, that's how she fared throughout. Lost out to Wodoyo, who's on court one right now against Mia Blickfeld. She also lost to Lena Christofferson as well, of Denmark, in straight games. So here's the profile of Kosetskaya, the Russian. Just one spot off her career high of 21 in the world. So she's been right up there, and well, she lost out to Mia Blickfeld, who's actually had a win, I'm pretty sure, over on one now. Leveled the score to a 1-1 in the Danish-Indonesian clash over on show court one. That was 21-18 in the deciding game after 55-minute effort. Iris Metspalu of Estonia in the hot seat. Stefan Vinet of France, a service judge. So, two-fifths of the way through, and it is NBFR Russia who are leading 2-0 in this one. Of course, Kosetskaya wins, the Russians win the tie, but all five matches will be played out. So 9 years senior to her opponent today. Kosetskaya. How will she go? Mm-hmm. Tearing out of the gates is the world number 22. Really solid start from her. So much so that her teammates have got their eyes down on them. Various mobile devices, fingers whirring around. They look pretty carefree, don't they, with their two lovely now, the Russian support camp. Nice disguise there with the reverse slice from Rachel Chan. That was great. Can she build on it? Many of their frontline players like Michelle Lee, Mitchell Hondrich, Kirsten Tsai, Josephine Wu on the female side. So suddenly Mitchell Chan gets thrown in the hot seat on a regular basis. Great for her development, and she's embraced it really well. But she is winless, 0-2 in singles. Coming in. And a loss in the doubles as well. So it's all uphill for the Canadian team. She's fighting really hard hill. Very high skill over there from Evgeniya.
Court one, 20 seconds.
Wonderful shot from Rachel Chan there. That was very high skill level across that. Perfectly weighted. Let's see it again. Look at this. Bang on. Straight smash from the top draw though in response immediately from Kosetskaya.
I'm going to see this by Gigi.
8-4 becomes 7-8 with three in a row for Canada. Oh, lovely disguise there from Evgeniya. Great deception, just a slight of the fingers and the wrist. Lovely done. So buoyed by a three-point cushion, Kosetskaya heads out to an 11-8 lead after 6 minutes played. Found it. 11-13. Yeah, nibbling away nicely at the arrears. Again, she's finding the back line of the Russian. Really on a regular basis now is Rachel Chan. This is encouraging for the Canadians. Thank you. Evgeniya fully aware that she needs to really step on the gas right there and play and contested a really solid point, very high intensity. Knowing that Rachel Chan had upped the level, got a little nibble off the top of the net there as well. It all helps.
13-14.
Just missed that one.
16-13.
Oh, she's found it right in the corner. Beautifully weighted because it's got. After that recent surge of 3 points in a row, certainly Rachel Chan right up against the solidity of the Russian wall the other side of the net. That's glorious though. What a response from the teenage Canadian, digging very deep here. Very good with that cross net. We've seen that a couple of times now. Oh yes, slightly greater weight of shot, but also with a slightly faster end as well. 4-point lead for Evgeniya Kosetskaya now. 26-year-old on a mission, seemingly. Oh, beautiful reverse slice, and Kosetskaya didn't even flinch barely there. He's back, Vladimir Malkov, just come in the nick of time to watch his countrywoman secure game one. So one other game point saved by Rachel Chan, what else has she got? Chantering away to herself in frustration, Kosetskaya feels like she should be at the change of ends already. Three in a row at the death of the game for Rachel Chan, who's not done with this opener quite yet. Kosetskaya will have to refocus here, because the charge from the Canadian has momentum. That's gone long, and eventually, after a nervy passage towards the final point, Evgeniya Kosetskaya sees off the first game after 16 minutes, 21 points to 18. Coach has advised that Rachel Chan takes on Evgeniya Kosetskaya at the net a little bit more. Nice return, delicate touch. Evgeniya Kosetskaya. Super play from Chan, really explosive. Oh, that's wonderful. Closed it down so well there. Gave herself multiple options because of her athleticism. That was really nicely done. Nice skill level. Good set play. Too greedy there, though. She feels bad. She's bashing the shuttle around at the end of points that she loses, and she's being a little bit sort of almost petulant at times, and then holds her racket up apologetically as if to say, I didn't mean to do that, sorry. That's missed. Leg call from the Lions judge. He took a while to split his hands. Two and the wingspan greater, it's got to help. Though Rachel Chan, take her lightly at your peril, she's pretty nifty around the court. Oh yes, four out of the last five have gone the way of the Russian, who looked stone-faced and said respectfully, just at times just a little disinterested, but it's just her way of looking, it's her focus, it's how she rolls. She's playing her trade very professionally. Almost at home. Rachel Chan is so quick, she almost made that. Out, good leave from Kosetskaya again. Defense is intact, turned the point around beautifully, the world number 22 there. Really well done. You never look, know whether she'd won a point or not, judging from that reaction. Great level of focus going on here, and it has to be. Really well done, Rachel Chan, watching the shuttle like a hawk there. Again, to the mid-game interval is Kosetskaya in the driving seat. 3-point cushion, 25 minutes played. Yeah. Well, the recent surge from Evgeniya Kosetskaya of 5 consecutive points have put her in the driving seat here. Game 2. Oh, nicely done. Wonderful cross smash from Rachel Chan, who's having to really go to the trenches today to contest this. It's the exquisite touch of the Russian. Seen many challenges, but here's one. Richard Chan has challenged this one. It was called out, and it was indeed quite a way out. A few unforced errors is Rachel Chan now. And I guess that's what starts to happen when you're 0-2 coming in here, haven't yet won a match. But you know, this is very high level international competition. It is not easy. She's played some tough competitors. Davlatova and Alimov watching on keenly.
16-11.
Beg your pardon, that might have been Malkova. Suddenly pushing the button on challenges on a regular basis is young 17-year-old Rachel Chan. Yeah, that one was spurred out of desperation more than anything, you sense, as the scoreboard is ratcheting up against her. Kosetskaya just 2 points away from victory now. Oh yes, well played. Must win points for Rachel Chan. She saved one of them. Into the corner as well. Beautiful precision from the 17-year-old Canadian. Oh, three of the match points have been saved now. Oh yes, but in the end, the straight smash secured by Evgeniya Kosetskaya, and she makes smooth, trouble-free passage through her women's singles clash in just 33 minutes, coming through 21-18, 21-15. So it is NBFR who head out to win the tie, 3-0. But we'll still be bringing you the men's doubles and the women's doubles hereafter. But for the moment, Russia win the tie. Kosetskaya secures victory and a heady 3-0 lead for them. Pleased with that. The world number 22, safely home and dry, 26 years of age. A good professional showing from the former world number 21. So coming up next is men's doubles, Yokura and Yang, the man who beat Jonathan Christie a couple of days ago in singles. Brian Yang, the 19-year-old, he's up in action against Vladimir Ivanov and Ivan Sozanov. Don't go too far. Welcome back, Badminton fans, to day four, an ultimate day in the group stage matches. We're watching a Group C encounter between Canada and NBFR.